A very good morning to all my students. Today we are going to have a maths class and the topic that we are going to do today is Roman numerals. So before we move ahead, let's have a quick recap of what we understand by Roman numerals. Roman numeral system is the numeral system that was used in ancient Rome. It has 7 basic symbols. Okay, so Roman numeral has 7 basic symbols. Can you see this 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 7 basic symbols that we use while writing Roman numerals. So this one is 1, then 5, 10, 50, 100, 500 and 1000. So these are the basic symbols of the numbers given. Okay. So we have to keep this chart in our mind and you have to learn it very well. Okay, you have to learn which number represents which symbol. Clear? Then only you will be able to solve out your Roman numerals. For that, you need to know some basic rules. Okay, there are 3 basic rules that you need to know when you are writing Roman numerals. So let's start with rule 1. What it says, when a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it is repeated. So the symbol that we are repeating, it keeps on adding. Clear? So what we need to remember, only 1, 10, 100 and 1000 can be repeated. Okay, that means 1, 10, 100 and 1000 can be repeated. Clear? Now, one more thing that we have to remember, a symbol can be repeated up to a maximum of 3 times in a number. That means 1, 10, 100 and 1000 can be repeated only 3 times, not more than that. Clear? So you can only repeat it up to 3 times. If you are repeating it more than 3 times, your answer will be wrong. Okay, so let's take example of rule 1, where we can repeat 1, 10, 100 and 1000 up to 3 times, not more than that. So supposingly if I repeat 1, 1 and 1, what does that mean? That means 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is 3 according to Hindu Arabic. And when we write this in Roman numerals, we write it in this way. 3. Now if I am repeating 10, that is 10, 10, 10. So I cannot repeat one more. I cannot write it 4 times because that is not in the rule. So I can write 3 times at the most. So what does that mean? 10 plus 10 plus 10. That is 30. And in Romans, how do we write? 10, 10, 10. We write it in this way. Next, this is 100. That is 100 plus 100 plus 100. How much it comes? It comes 300. So you can write it like, okay. And then thousands. Thousand plus thousand plus thousand will give you 3000. That comes to M. In Roman, we write it like this. So we cannot write this, that is 1, more than 3 times. We cannot write 10 more than 4, 3 times. I mean, we cannot write 100 more than 3 times. We cannot write 1000 more than 3 times. So we have to know that 1, 10, 100 and 1000 we can repeat up to 3 times only. So one more thing you have to remember, that 5, 50 and 500 are never repeated. Clear? So 5, 50, 500 are never repeated. Only 1, 10, 100 and 1000 are repeated up to 3 times. Clear? Now rule 2 says, when a symbol of smaller value is written to the right of a symbol of greater value, the smaller value is added. The smaller value is added to the greater value. Supposingly, if we have a number here, okay, this is in Romans. So how, what do we understand by this number? So this is what? This is 5 and this is 1. So 1 is written in the right side, okay? 1 is written in the right side of the greater value. So this is what? 5 is my greater value and this is 1 is my smaller value, isn't it? So 5 is my greater value and 1 is my smaller value, and 1 is written in the right side of greater value. So that means 5 plus 1 will give me 6. Let's take example. Now again, 5 is my greater value and this 1 are all small value. So these are all written in the right side. Can you see? These are all written in the right side. So my greater value is 5 plus all the small values are in the right side of the greater value. I mean greater value. So I will add 1 plus 1 plus 1. So how I'm going to read it? 5 plus 1 6 plus 1 7 plus 1 8. So it is 8. Next. Now see here, this is bigger number, that is the greater number, then the second greatest and then the smallest. Okay, so this is small comparative to the greater number. So I can write here small only. Okay, so small, small and small. So this is smallest, smaller and this is greatest. So these are what? In the right side. Okay, these are all in the right side. So my here the greatest number, that is 500. So D is the symbol of 500. Then plus this is what? 10 plus 1 plus 1. So it comes to 500 plus 10 is 510 plus 1 plus 1. That is 11 and 12. That comes to 512. Next, take another example. So again, this is my greater value. This is smaller. And this is smaller than this. So these are all in the right side. So here my greater number is which one? It is 100 plus, then 10 is in the right side. So I will add 10 plus 5 is in the right side. So I will plus 5. So it comes to 115. Clear? So these are the ways that you have to keep in mind, that all the smaller numbers are in the right side. So whenever you have all the smaller numbers in the right side of the greater number, you will simply add. Clear? Now rule 3 says, when a symbol of smaller value is written to the left of a symbol of greater value, the smaller value is subtracted from the greater value. That is, the smaller value is subtracted from the greater value. So we have to keep these 3 points in our mind. We have to remember these 3 points very well. That 1, can be subtracted from 5 and 10 only. Okay, 10 can be subtracted from 50 and 100 only, and 100 can be subtracted from 500 and 1000 only. So you have to keep this in mind. Okay, which symbol will be subtracted from which greater symbol? Now 1 cannot be subtracted from 50. You cannot subtract 1 from 100. Okay, you cannot subtract 10 from 500. You cannot subtract 10 from 1000. So you have to keep this in mind, that 1 can be subtracted from 5 and 10 only, 10 can be subtracted from 50 and 100 only, and 100 can be subtracted from 500 and 1000 only. So you have to keep these 3 points in your mind. Now let's move to the examples. So let's take example of 4. So now this is 5 and this is 1. So 5 is my greater number and 1 is my smaller number. So now 1 is in the left side. See, 1 is in the left side of the greater number. So what do we understand here? That is 5 minus, this is 5 minus 1 will give you 4. So whenever the smaller symbol is in the left side of the greater, then you will understand you have to subtract. Let's take example of this. Now this is greater, that is, this is 100, and this is smaller, this is 10. So this is greater and this is smaller. So my smaller is in the left side. Can you see it's in the left side of the greater value? So that means 100 minus 10 will give you 90. Done? Now, this is greater number and this is my smaller number, because this symbol represents 50 and this symbol represents 10. So 10 is smaller than 50. Okay, so this is in my left side, that is 50 minus 10 really is 40. Okay, and let's come to the last one. Now this is my 1000. Okay, that is my greater number, and this is my 100, this is my smaller number. So smaller one is in the left side of my greater number. So this is 1000 minus how much? 100. Okay, minus 100 will give me 900. Clear? So there are 3 rules that we have to keep in mind when we are doing our Roman numerals, and we have to also remember the key points which I have provided.